So hello everyone there, we are up with another part of this chapter, Reflection of Light. So let's study. I hope you must have watched the previous part of this video, of this chapter. So firstly we will study what is principal focus and focal length of a concave mirror. So as we have studied about plane mirrors, their principal focuses, focal length, center of curvature, etc., principal axis as well. So now we are going to study about the spherical mirror. So what are spherical mirrors? There are two kinds of spherical mirrors. One is the concave and the another is convex mirror. So we will study about the principal focus and focal length of the mirrors. What kind of mirrors? Spherical mirrors. Okay. So firstly we will study about the concave mirror. So first we will again understand what is principal focus and focal length. Okay. So, you can call focus as half of the radius of that sphere, that spherical mirror. You can call principal focus as the half of the radius of spherical mirror, or you can call it half of center of curvature. Okay, we've studied this formula. There is a formula where they state that principal focus is half of the center of curvature. That is radius, distance of center of curvature from pole. Okay, and what is focal length? Focal length is the distance of focus, distance of principal focus from pole. Okay, here we have a pole. Okay, here is a pole and its focus here. Okay, it is written here. Okay, so let's carry on. The principal focus of a concave mirror is a point on its principal axis. So, principal focus is a point on principal axis. So, what is principal axis? Principal axis is an imaginary line on a spherical mirror. Okay, we just imagine a straight line from a spherical mirror and just we have just named it as principal axis. So, principal focus of a concave mirror is a point on its principal axis to which all light rays which are parallel to the and close to the axis converge up after reflection from the concave mirror. So, as I have told you earlier, concave mirror is a converging mirror. And what is the meaning of converging? When all the parallel incident light rays, they just get reflect back and just gather at a single point. You can look here, they are gather at a single point. So this is called converging. Okay, and whereas diverging is the opposite of converging. All the light rays, they just scatter away. Okay, scatter away into different directions. So it has real focus. We are talking about concave mirror right now, not about convex mirror. So concave mirror has a real focus. Why are we calling it that it has a real focus? Because this side, where all the green, yellow lines are, this side is the reflecting part of the concave mirror. And this shaded region does not possess reflection of light. Okay, so we can call that focus is real in it. Because the focus is not behind. This is because the focus of the concave mirror is not behind the mirror. So this part is behind the concave mirror. Okay. Principal focus and focal length of a convex mirror. So as we have studied here about the concave mirrors, now we are going to study about the principal focus and focal length of a concave mirror. So let me explain you that the focus of a convex mirror is located behind the mirror. As you can see, here is a shaded region. So here no reflection will take place and here is a principal focus of diverging mirror or we can say convex mirror. So as the light rays, parallel light rays fall on this convex mirror, they just diverge or we can say they just scatter away from this point. We imagine that they scatter away from this point. So that's why the dotted lines are shown here. Okay. So the focus in convex mirror, principal focus in convex mirror is not real because it is behind the mirror. Okay? It has virtual focus. Virtual means which is not real. Focus is situated behind the mirror. We can see here the focus is behind the mirror. How can you say what things are behind the mirror and before the mirror, in front of the mirror? So this shaded region depicts the unreflecting surface of the mirror. Okay, here no reflection will take place. So this side is the back side of the spherical mirror. Now we are going to study the relation between radius of curvature and focal length of a spherical mirror. So what is radius of curvature? It is the distance between the center of curvature and pole. Okay, and what is focal length? It is the distance between principal focus and pole. So what is the relation between C and R? Sorry, R is the radius of curvature. So it can be represented as capital R. Okay, and focal length is written as small f. You can see here the focal length of a spherical mirror, whether concave or convex, is equal to the half of its radius of curvature. I told you earlier that I am going to explain it now. That focal length is the half of radius of curvature. And what is the radius of curvature? It is the distance between pole and center of curvature. Distance between P and C. So it can be written as F is equals to R upon 2. This means F is the half of R. What is R? R is radius of curvature and F is focal length. Okay? If you have any doubts related to any topic, you can ask me. So we will solve one problem of this formula. We got a formula here, F equals to R upon 2, where F is focal length and R is radius of curvature. So if the radius of curvature of a spherical mirror is 20 cm, so we have R equals to 20. What is radius of curvature? It is the distance between pole and center of curvature. And we need to find the focal length. So what we have? F equals to R upon 2. We need to find F. We need to find focal length here. So we just place the value of R in this, that is 20 centimeters, and we get the answer. F equals to 10 centimeters. So the focal length of this radius of curvature is, with this spherical mirror, is 10 centimeters. Now this is the most important topic. These are the rules for obtaining images by spherical mirrors. So these are some rules which you need to study to form certain images on both the spherical mirrors, concave as well as convex. So first we will study about concave mirror. We'll study about concave mirror. Okay, then we'll carry on with the convex mirror. We'll not understand this simultaneously together. Okay, it will create confusion. So a ray of light which run parallel to the principal axis. So first of all, what is the principal axis? This line is a principal axis. This is an imaginary line drawn with concave mirror or convex mirror. We call it principal axis. This is an imaginary line. Okay. So when a ray of light passes parallel to principal axis. So this is principal axis and this is the ray of light which is parallel to the ray of light. So after reflection, it passes through the principal focus F of a concave mirror. So we are talking about concave mirror. When this line AB, this incident ray of light falls on this concave mirror, then it reflects back from the principal focus. You always need to make such diagrams very neatly, otherwise your measurements and these lines won't get straight and correct. Okay. So this is incident light and this will always pass through focus. If you draw a parallel line to the principal axis, it will always reflect back through the principal focus. Here it is a pole, it is a principal focus, and here with the same distance, here is a center of curvature, that is C. Okay. Now let's come to the next rule. We'll study about this concave mirror after we complete the rules of concave mirror. All the all the things like focus pole and the center of curvature, incident ray and these reflected ray is in front of the mirror in case of concave mirror, whereas in convex mirror the principal focus and center of curvature is behind the mirror, as you can see the shaded part here. Okay, so let's come to the next rule. Second is a ray of light which is incident to the pole. It is incident to the pole. It falls on the pole. This is P. This is pole. Okay. It reflects back at the same angle, following the rule of reflection. As we have studied the laws of reflection, according to that, the angle of incidence is equal to the angle of reflection. You can see I and R here. Okay. So when an incident ray falls on pole, it gets reflected with the same angle. So it follows the laws of reflection, since angle of incidence is equal to the angle of reflection. Okay. Now third rule. You need to follow all these rules if you have to make any image position in a diagram. And these are so important things in this chapter. The ray of light which passes through center of curvature. So as I have told you that the distance between center of curvature, that is C, and F is same as F and P. As we have studied the formula, F equals to R upon 2. That means the focal length, this is the half of this hole. This means P, C equals to 2 multiplied by PF. That means this is the double. This whole part is double of this part. Okay. So when a ray of light passes through the center of curvature, when a ray of light falls on C, so it will reflect back from C only. Okay, as you can see here, this is an incident light falling on center of curvature. It will get reflected back through center of curvature. Okay, and this is the last one, last rule, fourth rule. The ray of light falls on principal axis and reflects back to the principal axis. The ray of light falls on the principal axis, principal focus. You can see here it is the principal focus. What is principal focus? It is F. Okay. So when a ray of light falls on F, then it gets reflected back to the principal axis. We have done an opposite rule of this. That is the first one. You can see there was a parallel line and it passed through the focus. And now what we are doing? There is a line incident to focus and it is reflected back parallel to the principal axis. So this rule, you can call it the opposite of the first one. Okay. Now we will study about the convex mirror rules. Okay. So this is a convex mirror. This part is the non-reflecting surface of the concave mirror. And a light is incident to the mirror and which is parallel to the principal axis. So this is the principal axis. Okay. There is a line which is incident to the principal axis and it is parallel to this. Okay. Then it is reflected back from the focus. It passes through the focus. So in this case, in the case of convex mirror, it actually does not pass through the focus, but we draw an imaginary line. We just imagine that this ray of light has reflected back from the imaginary focus. Okay, so let's come to the second one, second rule of for the convex mirrors. So this rule follows the law of reflection of light, where angle of incidence is equal to the angle of reflection. Okay, so when a light ray is incident on the pole of the convex mirror, then it gets reflected back with the same angle. Hence, angle I, that is angle of incidence, is equal to the angle of reflection. Okay. Now comes the third one. When a ray of light falls on the convex mirror, okay, then the imaginary center of curvature reflects it back into that same direction. As we have studied for the case of concave mirrors, The ray passes through center of curvature, C, and gets reflected back to that C itself. And same is here. Okay. Now comes the fourth rule. It is the opposite of first one. You can remember it like this. It is the opposite of first. When a light is incident on the imaginary focus, so you can see the dotted lines here. This means this focus is not real. We studied it earlier. It is not real. It is virtual. So when the light ray is incident on the virtual focus, it gets reflect back parallel to the principal axis. This is the opposite of first law. Fourth law is the opposite of first law. You can learn it by this. Now, one more important topic: formation of different types of images by a concave mirror. First of all, we'll understand the different types of image formation by concave mirror, and after that we'll learn it for convex mirror. So the type of image formed by a concave mirror depends upon the position of object in front of the mirror. So the type of image formed by the concave mirror is totally dependent upon the position of the object. The nearby object will create some different kind of object image, and the far off object will create different kind of image size and nature. So there are six conditions which we are going to study in detail. So these are the six conditions. These are the positions of the object on the mirror, near the mirror. Okay, so we'll study the first one. When object is placed between pole and focus of the mirror. So as you can see, this is a concave mirror. Here it is a pole, and this is this is the center of curvature of a concave mirror, and this is pole. When object is placed anywhere between pole and focus, so this is pole and this is focus. We have our object AB. This line AB with an arrow on the upside shows an object AB. So how do we form certain images using these diagrams? So we use any two of the rules of image formation. We have studied four rules earlier. You need to apply any two rules here. Okay, and I'll explain you how it carries on. So before understanding this first case, let us just study the second one, just to make the things easier. Okay, so the image position is at infinity. You can read it here. So we have our object at focus. We have our object at focus. So AB is an object. This is an object at focus. This is focus, and we need to apply two rules of image formation. Okay, so first one we have applied here, a line coming parallel to the principal axis and passing through the focus. This is our first rule. We are applying first rule here, that our incident ray is parallel to the principal axis and is passing through focus. Okay, this is the first one. The another rule will be, the incident rays passes through center of curvature, that is C, and reflected back into same direction. So we have applied two rules of image formation here. Now in image formation, what we do is, where the reflected rays meet, the image will form there. Okay, so we have two reflected rays, EY and DX. Okay, these are the two reflected rays of two different image formation rules. Okay, so these lines will not meet ever in future, since these both are parallel lines. So the image will form at infinity. You always remember this: whenever two lines are parallel, two reflected rays are parallel, then the image will form at infinity. We cannot define the position of image, it will be at infinity, and the image will be real and inverted. Real and inverted image means the image is not formed Real means the image is in front of the mirror. The image is not behind the mirror. Real image means the image which is in front of the mirror. And inverted image means the image below this principal axis. This is principal axis, and the images formed below this will be inverted images. So the image nature is real inverted, since the image is formed this side and is inverted. And the image will form very large. Highly magnified means the image will be very large, since it has been formed at infinity. Now let us come to the first case to understand. Or our object is between pole and focus, we can look here. When light rays fall on this object, we need to apply two image formation rules again. Okay, so light rays fall on this and they pass here. One more rule, that the incident light falls on C and reflected back through C. Then here is an eye. Okay, we'll extend these reflected rays. These are reflected rays, these both are reflected rays. We will extend these reflected rays at the back side of the concave mirror. So by extending, they will meet at this point, which is named as A dash. So our image will be A dash B dash. This will be our image. Since we have extended it here, so this is the intersection point of the reflected rays. Therefore, this is the image formed. This image is formed behind the mirror. It is virtual and erect. So what is virtual and erect? Virtual is an image which is formed behind the mirror, and erect means the images which is formed above the principal axis. So there are four terms: real, virtual, erect and inverted. I have explained you all four. These are so important. And this image is formed larger than the object. You can call it magnified also. So now let's come to the third case. When the object is placed between focus and center of curvature. So this is the object. We have applied two rules. When the ray is parallel to the principal axis and passes through the focus. Another rule. With the same rule, we have applied it this side. Principal axis parallel, ray incident, then it passes through the focus. Okay, then it passes through the focus and is parallel to the principal axis. So in the intersection is placed here, so this will be our image. In the same way, we have the fourth case. In this, the object is at center of curvature, so we will apply two rules for image formation. So the object is at C. First rule, line parallel to the principal axis and passes through focus. Another, line passes through focus and parallel through principal axis. So there are two rules for image formation. And the intersection point of both the reflected rays, this is the reflected ray for first rule, this is the reflected ray for second rule. Then the point of reflection, point of intersection for these reflected rays is A dash. And here the image will be inverted, since it has formed below the axis. The next case is, the object is kept after or beyond C. So we'll apply here same two rules, then we'll have the object here. Okay, all the things are written over here, you can understand now. The other is, when object is placed at infinity. So since the object is at infinity, we cannot define the location of that object. So we will have parallel lines passing through this mirror. Okay, so we have A and D parallel lines. So these will pass through focus. So the image will form at focus and it will be very small, since it is point sized. So this is a sum up the table for all these cases. We have shown position, size and nature of image in this single table. You must draw it. Now what are the uses of concave mirror? It is used for shaving mirrors. It is used by dentists, used as reflectors in torches, vehicles, vehicle lights, used as TV antennas, etc. Now we'll study sign convention for spherical mirror. What is sign convention? In this, we determine the sign of various units. Like if we are talking about height of the object, then the object in this side, object will be like this. So the sign of object will be positive. Like the height of an object is 10 centimeter. So 10 centimeter, it will be positive. How will it be positive? You must have seen any graphical representation. We have four quadrants. Like we have two axes, x-axis. This mirror is x-axis for us, and this principal axis is. This mirror is y-axis for us, and this axis, principal axis, will be x-axis for us. So according to that, this side is positive, this side is negative, this side is negative, and this side is positive. So similarly, all the units will be marked. Like we are talking about object distance, so it will be negative since this side of x-axis is negative. So this is sign convention for both the spherical mirrors. Now what is mirror formula? It is a formula which gives distance between image distance, object distance and focal length. Image distance is V, object distance is U, focal length is F. So 1 upon V plus 1 upon U equals to 1 upon F. This is our mirror formula. What is linear magnification produced by mirrors? It is the ratio of height of image to the height of object. So magnification is determined by small m equals to size of image upon size of object. And this minus di upon do. Do, do is object and di is image. Image height. Now formation of image by convex mirrors. There are only two cases in convex mirrors. One is when object is placed at infinity, and one is when object is placed anywhere on principal axis. So first we will study the infinity case. So since the object is at infinity, we will draw parallel lines. Okay, now these lines will, according to the rules, these lines will diverge by using the rule. This is a parallel line and it is passing through the focus. We have used one rule in this two times. Okay, so this will be our position. So image will be highly diminished, virtual and erect, and behind the mirror at focus. So here our image will be formed. This will be our image at when object is at infinity. Now we will study. We will do the second case. We will have the object anywhere on principal axis, then we will apply two rules, then the intersection of the two reflected rays will be the point of image form. So convex mirrors can be used as shop security mirrors, rear view mirrors in vehicles. So what is the difference between plane, convex and concave mirrors? Plane mirror produce image of same size, concave mirror produce magnified image, convex mirror produce small image. Magnified image means large image and diminished means small image. Numerical problem based on concave mirror. So we have object distance of 10 cm. It will be minus since object in a concave mirror is in this side. Like we have axis, we have a graph, then the object distance will be on the left side, so it will be minus. So similarly, all the signs will be put, and then you need to apply formula, mirror formula, and you can find focal length. Try this question. Same is with the convex mirror. You just need to take care about the signs, sign convention. You just note the sign convention and make a diagram of the mirror, and then you can solve the question. So thanks for watching the video. If you had any doubt related to any topic, you can ask me. Thank you.